You have begun your assistantships, I'm assuming, and getting moved and acclimated to the environment, so we're gonna just get you even more acclimated to the academic part, which is the most important part, which is why you're here, right? Yes. So today we're gonna do some welcome introductions. We're doing getting to know you exercise, and we'll go over the curriculum with you. Once again, each of you have, I'm sure, studied the curriculum. You're probably already registered, you will be registered. And then we have a special presentation from some of our students who went to South Africa last year and got practicum credit hours for going to South Africa. So we're gonna go again. They're gonna talk about their experiences in South Africa. And then we'll open it up for question and answer. But before we get started, we have some really, really important people here with us today, folks who make our lives easier on this campus and who are well connected to our program, to our department. I'm going to introduce them. First of all, I'm going to introduce the faculty who will be working hands-on with you on a day-to-day basis. First of all, Professor Amy French.
Hello.
And we'll do some more introductions, yes. but we want to get started. Dr. Richard Walker. Dr. Mary Howard Hamilton. Dr. Mark Frederick. She's in a whole different category.
To me, she's in a different
She's teaching.
Yep, you are. Okay.
I'm teaching.
So let me introduce her twice. She gets to come and make a speech as well. So, Dr. Denise Collins. She's my sister from another vista. We're kind of connected at the hip. We came here together. We're in our 13th year.
We are.
Wow.
Come through.
And so she and I are really connected at the hip. We came to this program together, this department together. Mm-hmm. And so it's exciting for the two of us every year to watch these things kick off every fall. Next, I'd like to introduce the Dean of the College of Education, who will come and bring greetings. After the Dean speaks, I'll do another introduction. Dean Candy Hill Clark.
Yes!
Hello, how are you? Great.
I was expecting a lot more enthusiasm.
Let's try that again. More student affairs. I'm a little bit concerned about that subdued. Have they already done some things to you this morning or something? Let's try that one more time and give it to me like you really are embracing SAHE and you're excited about being here with us in the Bible College of Education. Good afternoon!
Good afternoon!
As Dr. Hinton said, I'm Dr. Candy Hill Clark. I'm the Dean of the Bible College of Education. I am now entering my third year as Dean here, excited to be here. We had a wonderful kickoff celebration this morning where I had an opportunity to welcome back our faculty and staff. I did launch our quote of the year in the Bi College of Education. We have a quote every year. You will be discussing this quote throughout your experience throughout this academic year. My first year, the quote was, "Don't let what you can't do interfere with what you can do," by John Wooten. Song for year one was Katy Perry's Roar. Year two, our quote last year, "My life is my message," by Gandhi. Song of the year, "Shake It Off," by Taylor Swift. That was my jam. I had to shake some things off last year. Going into year three, here's the quote. You got your pen, you got your paper, you ready for it? Because I will be quizzing you on this. I have access to all classes. Quote for this year, by Dr. Maya Angelou, "Try to be a rainbow in someone's cloud." Try to be a rainbow in someone's cloud. In 2011, Dr. Angelou was on Oprah Winfrey's master's class. And during that interview, she spoke about this rainbow concept and what this meant to her. And she said, "Every time I went on a stage I was responsible for directing, or I taught a class. I took with me everyone who had been kind to me to that event. So that in that moment, I felt appreciated, I felt included, I felt supported, I felt valued. In the Bi College of Education, our responsibility is to not only challenge you academically, but to challenge you socially, emotionally, developmentally. We are also here to encourage you, to motivate you, to support you. You are a valued and appreciated member of this family. And at no time should you ever feel excluded from this family. So you think about that quote. Have discussions about that quote. And think about how in all of your interactions, your responses, your emails, your decisions, your actions, everything that you do and you say over these next 2 years and moving forward in your professional careers and in your lives, you think about, how am I being a rainbow in this moment, in that email, in my response, in doing this assignment, in collaborating with my peers and colleagues? So try to be a rainbow in someone's cloud. Song of the year? I'm Good by the Mowglies. You know that one? Some of you are like, I don't know that. Let me take care of that real quick before I sit down. Because you're going to hear it in the hallways. Brain has a plan.
Yeah, I saw it. It's great.
This is our song. The dean can dance a little bit. I'm good. One. We're good. We appreciate one another. We value one another. And we are good in that. Now, being good with yourself, I have a little quote in my office that says, be yourself because everyone else is taken. Right? So it's about being good with yourself, being cool with who you are, be your authentic self in this place and space. And we respect that and appreciate that. But it doesn't give you a pass to be rude, to be mean, to exclude others. You know, sometimes people say, well, that's just how he is. That's just how she is. That's an excuse. So you can be yourself, because truly everyone else is taken. So you are you. But you can always stretch yourself and try to grow and to develop, to own this experience and to engage in this experience. So as your dean, I welcome you. I'm thrilled to have you here. And there's one more thing I need you to do for me, because I have a little bit of an issue talking with people and I don't know them yet. So I want to get to know you so that when I see you in the hallways, when I see you across campus, like, hey, Dean, I'm like, hey, Terry, right? I want that connection with you. That's important to me. So I'm not starting here with you, Kelly, because you're right here on the edge, and that's predictable, and I'm a little bit unpredictable as a dean. So I'm going to start with Sean. Could you tell me who you are, where you're from, and anything else you want me to know?
Yeah, I'm Sean. I'm from Chico, California. It's about an hour north of Sacramento.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good. At least you know where you're going. That's important. You meet him.
Hi, my name is Josh. I graduated from the University of Maryland, Baltimore County with a history degree and a political science minor.
Uh-huh.
For the past 2 years, I worked on staff with Lambda Kappa Fraternity.
All right.
And so now I'm here continuing my education, and believe it or not, my assistantship is in fraternity and sorority life.
Get out of here. I lived in that world once upon a time. It's still with me. Yes.
I'm Yang. I was born in Ho Chi Minh City, Vietnam. My family and I moved here when I was two, and so I grew up in Fort Wayne, Indiana. I went to Ball State, majored in urban planning and development, and I'm with the training sorority life.
Pleasure to have you here with us.
I'm Leanne. I'm from Anderson area.
Mm-hmm.
I graduated from Purdue with a double major in political science and history.
Hmm.
Yeah, there's a lot of
okay.
And,
it's glad to have you here.
I'm working in campus life with weekend programs.
Okay, fantastic. Welcome.
My name is Molly. I'm from Evansville, Indiana, and I graduated from the University of Evansville with a degree in organizational communication.
Evansville!
Yes!
How was that? 10, 9,
we straight out of the Ville.
Oh! Okay.
And I'm in residence life.
All right. Thank you, Molly.
My name's Andrew. I am from Eagle River, Wisconsin, but I went to the University of Wisconsin, Green Bay. I graduated with a degree in art, and design arts is my minor, and I'm working in residential life as well.
Pleasure to meet you, Andrew. Welcome aboard. Hello, how are you?
I'm well.
Who are you?
Garion Woods, Garion D. Woods.
Garion D. Woods, in case you didn't get it.
D for driven.
D for driven, in case you didn't get that.
I'm originally from Lansing, Michigan. I spend most of my time in Garion, Indiana. I have an associate's from Vincent University in secondary education, and my bachelor's from here in African American Studies, and my assistantship is with University College.
Fantastic, Dr. Linda Mall. All right, pleasure to meet you once again, Dr. Woods. That's how I felt. You're like, I'm driven. Maybe that D stands for that one day. Who knows? Hello, Joshua. How are you?
Oh, I'm doing well. I'm Joshua Elmore. I am from Terre Haute. I graduated my undergrad in philosophy here from Indiana State.
Go Sycamores?
Go Sycamores. And I've been working over at the Student Union full time for the past 4 years. And I'm a distant student.
Okay, fantastic. Welcome. Glad to have you here. Pleasure to meet you. Sarah.
Hi, I'm Sarah. I am from Wisconsin. I went to the University of Wisconsin, Madison. And my assistantship is in residential life.
Fantastic. Pleasure to meet you. Welcome. Jess.
Hi, I'm Jess. I'm from the Upper Peninsula, Michigan, and I just graduated with my biomedical engineering degree from Rose Holman down the street, and now I'm doing my assistantship there.
Fantastic. My husband works there. He's the director of professional development. Pleasure to meet you.
My name is Zach. I went to Marywood University, which is in Scranton, Pennsylvania. I graduated with my degree in physical activity, exercise science. My assistantship is here within ISU in Rose Life.
Fantastic. Pleasure to meet you. Hello.
Hi.
I know, but I'm not sure.
My name is Olivia Finley, and I graduated in May from Indiana State with a political science degree and a legal studies minor, and my assistantship in the next few years is in University College as well, so.
Fantastic. Dr. Linda Mall as well. I have to tell you a little bit of a secret. Olivia taught me how to do a selfie. I now know how to do it. Olivia, who is our past Student Government Association president, so thank you for that. I'm getting pretty good at it. Yes.
I'm Caroline Park. I graduated from Franklin College this past May with the Bachelor of Arts degree in History and Political Science, and I'm doing my assistantship with the Career Center.
Oh, wonderful! Fantastic! I'll jump back over here to you, Kelly.
Hello, I'm Kelly Yanking. I'm from Terre Haute. I just graduated in May here with Human Resource Development undergrad.
Oh, fantastic.
And I work full-time in honors as a program.
All right, fantastic. Pleasure to meet you. Hello, Tyler.
Hi.
Who are you?
Away.
I know. Well, the name tags are homing me.
I'm Tyler Roberson. I graduated here over the summer. My bachelor's degree was general studies with a concentration in speech language pathology and educational psychology. My assistantship is with Dr. College.
Okay, student success, Josh Powers. Great. Hello, Natalie.
Hello. Well, I'm Natalie. I grew up about an hour north of Detroit in Washington, Michigan. However, I graduated from the University of Buffalo, New York, and my major was communication with a minor in art, and I'm with residential life.
Okay, fantastic. Welcome.
Hey. I'm Taylor. I am originally from Orange County, California, but I went to school at Chico with Sean, and I studied English, and I am with residential life.
Fantastic.
I'm Mitch. I am from Marietta, Georgia. My undergrad is in business. And I'm also
the
best
control center.
Fantastic. Welcome.
Yes, Joe.
I'm Joe. I went here for my undergrad, and I graduated in December with a degree in instrumental music education. Mm-hmm. I guess for the past 2 years, I was working as a safety inspector in construction and industrial, and now I'm with residential life.
Fantastic. Welcome.
My name's Katie. I graduated in May with an elementary education degree from here.
My name is Allison. I graduated with poli sci in history from Western
University. Yes.
And my assistantship is the American Democracy Project.
All right, fantastic. Welcome. Glad to meet you, Allison. Well, on that note, I'll have a seat because I think there are other people who may want the floor. So welcome and congratulations. And I look forward to seeing you around. What's the quote?
You
Rainbow. And what's the song?
I'm good.
Because why? We are good.
You'll find that we don't take ourselves real serious. We have fun. Okay, and that's what student affairs is about. So loosen up, get ready for it. As a matter of fact, I see you found a real use for those things. What your name? They're not roach clips.
You don't have that kind of thing.
Those are exactly what you got them for. Notes, pictures, name tags. Y'all know. I mean, that don't happen in college anymore. It was just when I was in college. Okay, I was going to do the things office. No. So
I am not following her again.
Okay, so another really important young man who joined our team this year. We're so excited to have him. He's none other than our Vice President for Student Affairs, Dr. Willie Banks.
So there are a couple of things I have to share with you. One, I absolutely detest having to follow Candy Hill Clark. I'm serious. I mean, really. I mean, do I have to follow that? She's amazing. So give her another round of applause. Another thing is, for those of you who don't know me, I've only been at Indiana State for 3 months. I actually was at Cleveland State for 3.5 years prior to joining the Indiana State family. And then prior to that, I was at the University of Georgia for 18 years, and that's where I did my master's and my PhD work. So let me just share with you, in the fall of 1993, I was in the very same situation as you guys. Don't add that up, that's been a long time. And I still look good. So, the fall of 1993 is when I started my journey, really, in student affairs, and I was in, at that point in time, it was called Student Personnel and Higher Education Program at the University of Georgia. And that time, I was, Roger Winston and Ted Miller were on faculty. So when you read your textbooks and you read Winston and Miller, I actually had them in class. And so Denise, Mary, I mean, yes. We know these folks, and you guys will know them once you start your coursework. And so I am thrilled, first, to be a part of Indiana State. But the second thing I'm really thrilled about is being a part of the College of Education and the SAHE program. I just want to share with you that when I was in graduate school and I was at the University of Georgia, we had a very strong connection with the Division of Student Affairs. And when this position came open, I actually made a campus interview. One of the things that I was very excited about was the possibility and the opportunity to teach in the College of Education, specifically in this program. Because I think the journey that you're about to embark on is so important, and what you're learning in the classroom is so important, but what you're learning there and how you translate that to the workspace is such, it's even more important. And I want to be a part of that journey with you guys. So my commitment to everyone here is that you're going to see me, you're probably going to get tired of me, but for me, that's what I know. My professors, Diane Cooper, Laura Dean, Marilee Dunn, all these people, they instilled in me that I have to give back to my College of Education, to the program, and to you guys, because you guys are the future in the second year that we're here. You guys are the future of the profession. And so we have to do the most amazing job that we can from this side of the room and this institution, so when you leave, that you're going to be a proud sycamore, but then also, more importantly, you're proud to be in student affairs, and that you're going to be proud to have a student affairs degree. Okay? So I look forward to working with each and every one of you. I know that I'm going to be working with the faculty and trying to come up with ways for me to get into the classroom. You know, I really hope that we can do some professional development, that I'll see you guys at NASPA and ACPA, that you guys can come and shadow me. We're going to figure out something, but you need to get used to me. So you need to get used to this face. You need to get used to me, and I might try to come up with a quote or a song.
You're part of this family, so that is
that's
your
true.
Song.
That's true. That's community steel. That's me. I'm going to come up with something else.
Okay.
We're going to come up with something else.
Okay.
But before I sit down, I need to actually take a picture of you guys, because one of the things that I'm doing as the new VP is now on Twitter and Instagram.
That's right.
And there's always an opportunity to do research or to write or journal or something. So here's what you all need to think about. So this is my first year. So I'm actually documenting my first year as a VP at Indiana State via social media. So my commitment is every day that I'm doing something and trying to document what am I seeing, who am I seeing, the students that I'm interacting with. So I would like to take a picture with all of you guys. Okay? I don't know if we're going to do a selfie or not. I don't know if we're going to do that. Yeah, maybe we should do that. And you guys, oh, here's another thing. You guys keep losing that. No, 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 no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no,
no, no, no, no,
no, no,
Okay, we're going to do a selfie. I've never used a selfie stick.
So this is a recommendation.
This is deep.
Use a selfie stick.
But can I
follow up?
I'll see.
Yeah. Hey, you need to do that.
This is cool.
I'm going to bomb you too.
Photo bomb somehow.
You might have standards.
Okay, you guys need to get a little closer. Everyone shower today, I hope. Everyone reach in, everyone smile. One, two, three. I like this angle because I don't have too many chats here. One, two, three. All right, did it take a picture? It's a ringtone. Wait, here we go. One, two, I don't know. Okay, one, two, three. All right, there we go.
Well, I guess we'll have to look at
it. This is all on Twitter.
I prefer Instagram, though. I don't have Instagram yet.
I love this. Thank you, guys.
That's a fancy little thing.
Let's give Vice President a hand. So what did you mean we have to follow you on Instagram and Twitter?
Yes, it's BPSA Willie Banks.
BPSA Willie Banks.
Yes.
And at Dean Hillmark.
At Dean, are you on Instagram also?
I'm on Twitter only.
Okay.
At Dean Hillmark, no hyphens, all one.
We'll post those.
Yeah.
We'll put it up.
We'll post those.
Thank
you.
You got it?
Got him.
So, moving on, in the dean's office, you kind of met her a few minutes ago. I said she's my sister from another district. And she is none other. She's the former, she served as the coordinator for this program for many, many years, built it to where we are now. We are a world-class, world-renowned program. And we're going to move it. You guys are taking us to the next level. So let me introduce to you
SAHE to the next level. SAHE 2.0. You know, I say SAHE. Another word that people say, SAHE. It just makes me go like that. But it's okay. It's your program. You call it what you want. But I am so thrilled to be here and to welcome you back. We have a wonderful program. We have amazing partners in the dean and the vice president, all of the faculty, our department chair, and our department administrator of assistants. And it's just a wonderful, wonderful place to learn and grow. I don't have a quote for everybody for the year, but I have one that I learned this summer, I heard this summer, that I think applies here too. I talked about this morning, but I think it applies here too. Because we're trying to build you into being strong student affairs professionals. And that's sometimes going to be difficult work. You're going to learn a whole lot of stuff. You're going to learn a lot about yourself. And you're going to learn about the students whom you are serving and the faculty and the staff whom you are
embracing and working alongside of. And as you embark on this journey, this educational journey, here's the quote. I need to see what I need to see, even if I don't want to see it. I need to hear what I need to hear, even if I don't want to hear it. Mm-hmm. I need to learn what I need to learn, even if I don't want to learn it. We are all here to help you see and hear and learn all that you need to become a student affairs professional, to embrace the values of our profession, the grounding of our profession, which is in the belief of the power and dignity of the whole student, and every student as an individual. So I'm excited to be a part of your journey. I'm so pleased to be co-teaching with Dr. Walker this fall, and so I'll get to know each of you much better, and you'll get to know me much better, and I'm really glad to be back. Every couple of years, I get to come back to the classroom and really fulfill my own soul as I'm working with students in this program. So welcome. I look forward to working with you.
One cohort named this program DC University, mm-hmm. because at one point Denise was running this thing almost by herself, so they named it DC University.
DCU.
DCU.
They even have the diplomas, and the mascot was a purple squirrel. It's true, but
a furry thing. Yeah.
Oh, no.
Okay. Now, if I could introduce to you some people who have been very instrumental in getting you here as well, starting with our department chair, Dr. Steve Bruner. Would you come forward, Dr. Bruner?
I don't have a whole lot to say. I'm sorry, but I've been often accused of being a quiet person. I just embrace my introversion.
Embrace.
Welcome. Pleased to understand. Know that you're in good hands. You've got some really good people here. It is a very renowned program. A lot of people want to get in there to get through it. And once you're finished, don't stop there. Get your doctorate and go be a president of the university someplace. I'm not kidding. Really do it, because the best presidents come from student affairs. You really do. What's a roach clip, by the way?
We're going to Denver to Ash this fall.
I see.
Okay, so, and then I know you guys have been in contact with these two wonderful women in our department at some point. You've called them, you've talked to them, you've emailed them, but trust and believe, this would not happen without them. And let me introduce, come forward.
Please.
Karen and Rhonda. Karen Buchholz and Rhonda Beecroft. You guys have got any words of wisdom for them? I mean, these folks got to register, they got classrooms for us.
I know you get frustrated sometimes trying to be the new person and work your way through this system that is sometimes crazy. So it's my job to help you go through that. So anytime you have questions, you can't find someone you're looking for, just give me a call, shoot me an email. I leave the office at 4:30 as often as Steve allows me to. So if it's an emergency, shoot me a message as fast as you can. I'll try to take care of it before I go home. This woman, on the other hand, doesn't quit work. If you send her an email at midnight, she'll hear it ping on her iPad, and then you'll freak her out. So stop messaging her at 4:30.
I am really bad about trying to keep an eye on that email all the time, but
I'm not quite as bad as midnight most of the time, but I'm here for Karen's backup. I usually work closely with the K-12 group, and Karen's got the higher ed side of things. But no matter what you need, Karen's going to take good care of you. If she's not there, I'm here.
Ask the faculty now to come and just introduce yourself, what you'll be teaching, perhaps what you're interested in terms of research or topics or favorite thing to do. Faculty.
You guys
were
teaching this fall.
And I do ask that everyone comes and stands kind of where Dr. Hinton is, so that our distance friends can see us as well.
We're recording this for our distance students.
Oh, okay.
Dr. Mary.
Awesome.
Now?
Well, I'm not teaching. Hi, everybody. My name is Mary Howard. I'm not teaching you this fall, but you'll be seeing me throughout the semester. I'll be coming to visit Dr. Richard Walter's class, Professor French's class. I'll be sitting in, observing, providing support to my new colleagues. And I believe I'll be again floating around again next semester. I do want to say that even though that I teach a lot of my classes in the higher ed doctoral program, I do want to encourage you, if you're interested in future research and if you're interested in the doctoral program in the future, please feel free to come by and stop by and see me at any time. I am the facilitator and coordinator of the South Africa Study Tour. You'll hear more about that a little later. The only other thing I want to encourage you all to do is to make sure that you make a mental note to yourself. There are going to be a lot of organizations thrown at you this semester, ACPA, NASPA, KUHO-I, all of the career services types of organizations. NASPA, the National Association for Student Personnel Administrators, it will be held in Indianapolis March 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, something like that, during our spring break, actually. But it'll be held in Indianapolis. I really would like to see close to 100% participation. I'd like to see everyone there. Even if you come in for a day, come in for our reception, Dr. Banks is going to be hosting our reception. Even if you just come in for a day, you have to come. As first year people, you'll rarely have an opportunity to have a national convention at your back door. This is rare. Okay, and you'll get to observe what it's going to be like for you next year when you're going to be looking for a job. You're going to need to be there to network. So I encourage you to put that on your agenda. Come to Indianapolis next spring to NASPA. ACPA's in Montreal, that's another story. It's going to be a little bit further away. But those of you who are passport ready and want to go, I'll see you there as well. Okay? So welcome, and I'll be seeing you. I'll be seeing you throughout the academic year.
Dr. Richard Walker is who I am, and we'll get to know each other real well. Aren't you lucky, right? Yeah, come on now. Show me some love with that. So anyway, I'll be teaching the intro to student affairs, as well as co-teaching the
techniques of interpersonal interaction.
That's a long one. That class. And likewise, my final course will be the multicultural class, which you'll have your second year. So, welcome again. And I came here BFMU. You're sitting still. That's okay. But where they strike. I'm just saying. So, okay. We'll move on.
Well, how can you follow that? I am Amy French. I will be teaching in the master's program with you all. I don't believe I will have you the first semester. I'll be spending most of my time with program evaluation and the third practicum. And but if there are any distance students, I will have you in program eval this fall. So I look forward to that. Next semester, you all will have me in intro to student development theory, which is a fun class. Everyone always gets excited about theory, right? Yes. And the second year's gonna test, it's not that bad, right? And also working with the practicum course as well. So I welcome you all. I come from Kentucky Wesleyan College, was my undergraduate in Poli Sci. So I heard a lot of Poli Sci folks. I'm right there with you. I got my master's at Loyola University in Chicago in social justice. So my passion is very much in diversity and equality and inclusion. So you will hear from me in that, in all aspects, no matter what I'm teaching. So welcome, and that is who I am and who is next.
I tend to be a bit sullen as a person. Letting you get into the spirit of things.
Woo! That was a high level of excitement. I was pretty away with that one.
Slow the heart here a little bit. I'm going to be instructing group dynamics and leadership this semester. And as the second years will attest, every once in a while I sneak just a touch of theory in.
Just a little.
But I'm excited. I do some work on both. There are two departments in this this program and the K-12 program. I work with K-12 program as well and help with some dissertation support. If any of you have dreams of a PhD program, please seriously consider that. It's rather fun to spend several more years in college.
Okay.
Defer student loans, don't pay taxes. It's a great life, huh? But I'm glad to welcome you all to Terre Haute. I came here back when it was still, I think, Indiana State Normal School. As an undergraduate, and I escaped for 6 or 7 decades, but came back. So I just want to warn you right now that Terre Haute has a unique quality I like to call the social black hole. You can try to escape its gravitational pull, but eventually it will suck you right back in. So, assume that, got an auto here? Yeah. Assume you're all, from this point forward, Terre Haute natives, and we'll see you for eons to come. I'll see you in class.
Another colleague just joined us, and are again on the K-12 side. But you know what? Again, first of all, the Bi College of Ed is a family, yes. So we are seamless, and certainly in our department, Dr. Ryan Donlin, come up and wave. You can do the nay nay.
Hi, everybody. I just wanted to say
Dr.
hi.
Dr. Donlin, to the distance students.
The distance students can see.
Over to that corner near Kelly.
Right.
Here. Okay.
Hi, everybody. I'm Ryan Donovan. I have the great privilege and honor to be hanging out amongst such wonderful folks, you all included. So, if you're ever in my neighborhood, which happens to be right across the hall from my colleague, Dr. Walker here, please feel free to say hi. I'd love to hang out with you. I teach primarily in the PhD program in the K-12. And just hang out and try my best not to make a nuisance of myself. Again, welcome. I had heard what a good group of folks that we had the privilege and honor of recruiting this year, but up until standing in front of you today, I didn't know what a good looking group of folks we had in this group this year.
So. Well, thank you so much.
All right, see you.
Last but certainly not least, the second year cohort is here. A portion of them stopped by to say hello and to greet you and to welcome you. Would you guys stand there over in the hub? Yeah, just say your name.
Hi, everyone. My name is Tina. I'm a second year and I am in Fraternity and Sorority Life under Ray College Sorority Committee.
And these are the advice for the new cohort.
Be patient and positive.
Hi everyone, my name is Bart Stucker. I am one of the second years as well in the Office of New Student Transition Programs. I'm the one that's been emailing you a lot, so please direct all your email towards me. Piece of advice, utilize the Rec Center to relieve some of that stress that you're going to feel
come through.
A good healthy option.
Hi, I'm Jenny Hornaday. I work in the College of Graduate Professional Studies as one of their GAs, and I work a lot with Dr. Mary and Dr. Hinton on the recruiting efforts, so I see a lot of me. My advice, be flexible.
Okay.
You think that this is set in stone, be flexible. It'll change.
Okay, come through.
Great advice.
Hi everyone, my name is Brittany Allensworth. I did my assistantship in Fraternity Sorority Life last year, but going into this year, I just started my new assistantship with University College as an academic advisor. And my piece of advice would be that don't get too consumed into work and practice self-care, because if you're not your best, you can't give your best to your students.
Hi, I'm Jason Dollar. My assistantship is at the Career Center. I run a graduation survey. My piece of advice is that your time here goes so quickly, a lot faster than undergrad, so you need to take advantage of it and get as many diverse experiences and professional development and networking as you possibly can. And go to South Africa.
Yeah,
for
the James.
Come through!
My name is Brian. My assistantship is in residential life. Yeah, let's go for the piece of advice. Utilize the second years, either just for advice, someone to talk to, or if you want to borrow some books. I know I use second years a lot for that too, so I have plenty of books, and if they're the same books that I used last year, feel free to reach out and borrow them. So, yes.
Catherine's gonna, I see a second year. You want to introduce yourself now or later?
I can now, I guess.
Huh?
I can now.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so my name's Catherine.
No,
oh, it's okay. No, I promise it's okay. my name is Catherine Warren, and I just switched my assistantship, so I am now with Dr. Mary and Dr. Candace in the Yes. I didn't know the exact title. And my piece of advice is, I'm sure some of you might be a little overwhelmed already with things that you've heard and everything, but remember why you wanted to go into this program, and throughout the semester and the next year and even 2 years down the road, there might be times that you say, why am I doing this? I just want to leave. But remember how you feel, how you felt when you were interviewing and how you felt when you were applying, because there's a reason why you're here, and you'll remember that later on even when times get really stressful. So.
Okay, thank you. Right now we're going to get you up, so we're going to do a getting to know you a little bit better. So take a break, get some snacks, come back, and Dr. Walker is going to engage you further.
Thank you. Right.
Quick drive-by of the curriculum, and then we're going to move to the final presentation for the day. Open it up for questions for you. A lot of questions, and I know you do. My inbox tells me that you got lots of questions.
It's not what.
This is the curriculum. You guys are familiar with this. That's why you applied to the program. You've looked at these courses, and this is what it's going to take over the next 2 years for you to complete the master's degree in higher ed. So there are 39 required hours.
For the camera. I had to dim the lights for the camera.
Thank you. Yeah, that's fine. Thank you. The first few classes you will have, this fall you're taking intro, 637, techniques, and
Group Dynamics,
652. So those are the three courses you have for this fall. In the spring, you'll be taking Student Development Theory, 638. Your first practicum, which is 634. And at least 650, a programming guide.
They don't take programming council, but
they take it wrong. Okay. Legal issues.
Woo!
In the spring. Right? So these courses will fully prepare you for going into your second year and your summer. Your summer is when you take your second practicum experience, and you will do it hopefully
at a campus somewhere else other than Indiana State. We've had students to go as far as this past second year went to Berkeley, Derek went to Berkeley, right?
Mm-hmm.
California, and students go all kinds of fun and interesting places to do their second practical experiences. That's summer. Then you come back in the fall and you have 641 multicultural campus, program eval, and your third track.
Mm-hmm.
That's fall, your second year, you guys know. And then for the spring of your second year, you have
leadership,
environment, and 680. Professional seminar, which is your capstone. So you'll either do 680 as the professional seminar, or if you're interested in writing a thesis, you need to let us know today so that we can get you thinking about topics and get you started on writing a thesis. So if you want to write a thesis, you will take EDLR 699 instead of 680. Okay? And you can start probably taking those hours next fall and spring, but you don't want to start to write that thesis next fall. You want to start thinking about it now. So if you have a topic, you would have gathered the literature around it and then actually do a research project for your thesis. Yes?
I just want to just interject and say something real quickly. I did teach in the program this past spring, and I just want to just share a couple of just professorial conversation, I guess one can call it that. First thing is that my preference is to be called Dr. Mary or Dr. H.H. or Dr. Howard Hamilton. And I'd like for you all to make sure that you chat with your professors and understand what they would like to be called professionally before you just assume that it's a tradition to call the person by his or her first name. Particularly when we go to conventions and conferences, I would prefer being called by my professional handle than you all running up and saying, you know, hey Mary, if you don't mind. I mean, maybe it's an old person's thing, but that's just the way I'd like for you all to address me. The second kind of like professorial perturbation is students who don't read before they come to class. Everything is important to me, and I'm a stickler on reading, and my colleagues are as well. I expect you to be well prepared when you come to class and to not make excuses. Period. None. I understand that over half of you are in residence life. I understand you're on call. I understand that. I was a student affairs professional for 15 years. I know residence life is where the rubber meets the road. Been there, done it, been a dean, the dean of students. Been in orientation, multicultural affairs, I've been in housing, commuter life, judicial affairs, I've done it all, professionally, full time. I know it's extremely difficult and very, very arduous work. You are a student first, and then you're here because you're a student, and then the assistantship was given to you because you are a student in the master's program. You're not. If you were here as a full-time professional, and if you are here as a full-time professional, great, wonderful, but you were not hired as a full-time professional and taking courses part-time. You're a full-time student. So respect us just like you respect your grad assistantship supervisor. We want you to be well-prepared. We want you to be well-read. When you go to NASPA, this is one of my other perturbation issue. When you go to NASPA, I don't want you walking up to one of the world-renowned, internationally renowned researchers in the field and asking him or her, who are you? Okay? I don't want you walking up to Arthur Chickering and saying, who are you? Or what do you do for a living? I don't want you walking up to the theorists and to the professors, because you're going to meet them. You're going to be meeting them. I want you to say, I read your work. I'm in the da-da-da-da-da program, and they will be just as impressed with you as you are of them. And then last but not least, do your work, and don't assume that we are doing the same things that have been done here in previous years. This is a whole new crew, and you're a whole new group of students, and we don't have, this is a blank slate for us. I hope you treat us in the same way that, literally, none of the professors teaching you this year are the same professors who have taught in the past, which is for me,
new.
Absolutely, positively, the most fun thing about this program. We are rebuilding, and we're going to be hiring new faculty as well. So, you know, if you want to talk with folks about what they did last year, that's fine. But know that you all are starting a new tradition, and I hope that what you do is really take that seriously and start it out on it with just an amazing first year and first semester.
That's perfect. I appreciate that, and I hope you all appreciate it too. We really do take seriously your academic work. Again, that's why you as faculty members, as we create our syllabi, it's our syllabi, it's our expectation. We don't really care about what happens outside the classroom. That's point blank. It doesn't matter to us what your work hours are. It really doesn't matter to us what else is due from another professor. Please don't tell another professor, well, I got this to do in that class. It's like, I get that done before I get yours done. Please don't ever say that. That's another professorial because what's most important to us is what's happening in our classroom at that time. So please let your internship or your assistantship folks know that academics is job one, and your professors expect a high level, that you have read the material, that you have interrogated the material, that you are responding to the material, and not just regurgitating. We know when you come to class unprepared, you're just jumping. One thing I can't hardly take in class is a whole bunch of piggybacking. I want to piggyback off. No, come up with a new idea. I won't be in your classroom as a primary professor either this fall. But again, we will be in your classroom this fall at various times, and even in the spring. So we'll be very engaged with you. Again, I'm coordinator, so everything that you need, please, I'm your point of contact. Unless it's related to your class, but if it's related, anything with the program, I'm your point of contact. Nobody else in this college do you go to before you come to me.
just real quick, one caveat, and this is just strictly for the distance folks, that theirs may be a little bit different because they're just
yes.
Students. So we're recording this so you kind of have an idea of the program, you know, on the ground, but the sequence of courses may be different for those that are just students. Just to clarify that.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Yes, this is slightly different for our distance students.
I had a minor freak out.
Okay. No.
Can I get signed up for that?
No. The distance students' curriculum is slightly different, stretched out over time, and even programming vow is out of sequence. So distance students are taking programming vow this fall. So right off the bat, they're going to have some research skills that will serve them well for the rest of their time in the program. So. Distance folks, we will be talking to you and engaging with you a little bit more about the curriculum and how it's set up for distance. Now, let me shift a little bit to something fun. We had the opportunity to go to South Africa last year on a study tour that Dr. Mary Howard Hamilton directed and led, and it was a fabulous, life-changing experience. And Jason and Catherine, and I'm going to introduce Mr. Aaron Slocum, who is a graduate of this program. He's now a second year doctoral student in higher education, and he's our colleague because he works in student or in housing, residence life. And he'll talk a little bit more about his experience, who he is, as well as Catherine. And Jason, since you're here, you might as well jump in with them when you can. And so I'm going to introduce to you now Catherine Warren, our graduate assistant, and Mr. Aaron Slocum. Give them a hand. And so we have a Q&A session.
All right.
class. Not here. All right. So my name is Aaron Slocum. I got my undergrad at the University of Wisconsin, Parkside. I then came to Indiana State University to receive my master's. I was not necessarily in this room for orientation, but I was sitting where you once were. And then I went to Georgia for a year where I worked at Georgia College and State University in Millersville, Georgia. Got the little Georgia connection. And then I came back to Indiana State, worked a year, and then applied to the doctoral program. So that's a little bit about me.
And I'm Catherine, as you've heard already. I got my undergrad at Bethany College in West Virginia. Got my degree in communications and media art with a track in integrated marketing, as well as a minor in music. And I started the program here last year, and hopefully I finish this year. And so, like Dr. Candace said, we both, as well as Jason, we went to South Africa this summer, and that fulfilled, since we're in the master's program, that fulfilled our practicum experience. Aaron went because he's always wanted to go.
It was on my bucket list.
And it was for his class, so.
You got course credit.
Yeah, I did get course credit. Yeah. It substituted critical race theory. So, while they had a practicum, it was more of a course for me.
Okay. So you've been told that you have three different practicums during your time in the master's program. Your first one's going to start in the spring. And some of you might already know kind of where you want to go in student affairs and higher education once you're done with the program. But I do encourage you to kind of step out of your comfort zone and experience different fields and areas, because you never know. The field is small and there's going to be opportunities everywhere. So take these kind of opportunities, whether it's, you know, Red Life or Greek Life or going on an international trip, because they're going to broaden your experiences regardless.
And with the South Africa trip, I know we're going to go into a video, but I would like to let you know that we talk to professionals over there from all types of departments. We talk to professors, we talk to individuals in residential life, financial aid, we talk to individuals in HR. So going over there was amazing to see how they did things differently. But you will be able to connect that to your experience somehow, some way, back here, and what you do. So.
Yeah, and also just kind of going off of that, there are a lot of job opportunities internationally as well. So getting to experience something like this is a once in a lifetime opportunity. You know, we have a professor that isn't here anymore, Dr. Barrett, but he's done things all over the world. And so he's a prime example of where jobs are outside of the United States. So we have a presentation. I put it together. So there's some pictures of me in there. Sorry. And then we're going to, you know, just tell you about our experience as some of the pictures and videos come up. So I hope you enjoy.
I kind of got to stand right here because we're going to be talking over the music as well.
So
at the University of Pretoria, due to the apartheid, lot, their whole campus is surrounded by barbed wires, gates. There's really can't get in unless you see, check in with a security guard or a security official. Even leaving, leaving the university, they check your car just to make sure that you're not taking anything. We had an administrator on the Mamelodi campus that has to open up about four or five doors, seven doors, before actually getting to his actual office. Right here we have Bess. She was our campus host. She works in the office of, what I would say, the office of residential life over in South Africa at the University of Pretoria. The pictures you are seeing are from opening day. Open day. Open day is when they have the opportunity to bring everyone from all over South Africa to visit their campus and showcase classes, organizations, and all types of events. Otherwise, they wouldn't be allowed on campus during this day. So you get high schools from all over South Africa to come to campus on this day.
Which is what you see in these pictures.
I would say, to give you an image of these townships, very, very, very poor in regards to living conditions. No running water, no real houses, just shacks. Individuals have to go to an outhouse to use a restroom or an outside facility to take a shower or a bath. Very, very poor living conditions for individuals to be in.
Oh, so I think that, you know, going on this trip, this would be a great opportunity for you to see, because we can sit here and show you these pictures and we can talk about it. Aaron understands what I'm saying because he saw it too. Jason understands, he saw it. Dr. Mary and Dr. Candace understand, but you guys probably don't really understand what we're talking about because you guys didn't see it. So I would encourage you to potentially go on this trip next year, because it's nice to be able to share those experiences with people that are going to understand.
I would think in my reflection of being actually seeing the townships and how individuals are living there, it made me think about or reflect on how much money I actually waste in regards to seeing individuals really struggle just to get ends meet. It made me think about how blessed I was to be able to just go to Africa and just have food at my disposal, and individuals actually really fighting to survive there. So it made me reflect on that, and it made me think about how can I give back and how can I make a difference, even if it's on a small scale for me.
So the next part of this slideshow, it's some videos. We got to experience a lot of the culture while we were there. We went to something called Africa Day, so we got to see a huge performance. We got there a little bit late, but we still got to experience, you know, their dance and their wardrobe and their art. And so this is just some videos of us getting to experience that.
Yeah. University of Victoria students.
This was like a group of students on campus that we saw during open day. Yeah.
Like the West Wing.
So this is like their formal performance that we got to see. We were in the very back, but it was still like a very powerful experience. And their campus is diverse. They had, you know, like students of all different ethnicities. So when you look at this, you're not just going to see one race or what you think is going to be the race represented there. It's a pretty diverse campus. And this is just a prime example of what you see on the streets in these townships. People are trying to make money, so they're putting up performances. You get to know your professors really well when you go on trips like this, a different level than what you would get to know them in the classroom.
I think that's also one of the most benefits that you, will get is you are on this trip with doctoral students, your peers, and professionals. So you're able to tap into things that they are thinking about, how they're feeling, how would they relate that back to their home university. So you can tap into those thoughts and feelings. So I have to say, like, honestly, we didn't know their language.
Yeah.
So they're doing their song and dance in their native language. And even though we did not know anything they were saying, we just felt it.
And of course, you gotta go on a safari while you're in South Africa.
I would say the safari was...
We had a fun man.
You get so up close and personal to the animals, sometimes too close for my
life. Yeah, that rhino right there almost ran out.
So. Biggest
benefit for going on this trip?
I would say, to add on to that, the benefits you're going to get to be able to say you went to South Africa and had the opportunity to look at another educational system in a different country is going to set you aside peers when you're going to job search. It also will put you in a different perspective when you return home in regards to how you look at the world. My time in South Africa was, I think you're tied with a beautiful heartbreak because you are on an emotional roller coaster. 1 minute you'll be so happy, and then you make a left or a right turn, you'll be sad in regards to looking at people's living conditions. While in Pretoria, we did stay at the
Portillo Hotel,
which is, I would compare it to somewhere close to a Hilton. So the accommodations that we have were nice. I would say about 5-star. It included breakfast each morning. We had breakfast with one another, and then lunch, depending on the day, may would have been on your own or provided for you by our host. And then dinner was either provided for you or you have to purchase your own. In regards to every night, we will have, because you will see so much, we will have a reflection group. Every night we will have a reflection group, and in that reflection, we'll talk about things we were able to see and get those feelings out, because having that bottled in, it's just a lot to see. And I don't know, you just gotta let it out.
So that was just a little bit about our experience. Dr. Mary has already confirmed next year's trip, which is awesome because we didn't find out about the trip until like December, January, so things were really rushed. But if you are interested in this year's trip, which I really, really hope some of you are, these are the confirmed dates for next year. And you'll get an extra experience that we didn't get. We didn't go to Cape Town, so they're going to Cape Town, which is gonna be awesome. And then ending their time in Johannesburg. So those are the trip dates. Jot them down if you want to. Obviously, there's gonna be plenty of time for you to make this decision. You don't have to make it right now. All right, so you're about to see the price. Don't freak out. The students that do go are granted a $1,000 scholarship, and so this price that you see does include basically everything. It includes your transportation, it includes your meals, well, most of them. It includes the travel that you do while you're there, all of the sites that you go see, and so the hotel, yeah. So this is basically everything except for your own spending that you want to do on this trip. And you have basically all year to save up the money. There will be payment plans and deposits due certain times during the month. But I'm guessing, getting to know Dr. Mary, she can be semi-flexible. You know, if you say, hey, I know there's payment due on the 30th. I don't get paid until the 10th. She's willing to work with you on that. So don't let the cost freak you out or deter you from going on this trip, because it's an experience that if you wait to have enough money to go on trips like this, you're gonna wait the rest of your life to go on trips like this. So take the opportunities. And then, so if you are interested or you want more information, we'll be putting out more information throughout the semester, hopefully sooner rather than later. But if you do want to just talk to someone one-on-one, you can talk to anybody who went on the trip this past year. But Dr. Mary will have the majority of the information that you need. So you can email her. She's usually really quick about getting back. Or you can stop by her office, which is on the third floor in room 321D.
I think I just want to stress how life-changing this trip is, and I want y'all to all consider going. Don't let the money hold you back, in all honesty. You get to go to, four museums. We didn't talk about museums.
Right.
We went to four museums, the apartheid museum, Boy Truckers Museum,
Freedom Park,
and we went to, we missed one.
Mandela?
Mandela's house. So we were able to see all those museums and get a real sense of the culture while we were there. And
what about your
two cents? Sure. Yeah, it was just a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. It's really important to ISU to start up this partnership, and the president has supported it with the scholarship. You can build it into your schedule as a practicum. There's about 3 weeks in the summer that we get off anyway, so you can work with your supervisors to balance out those hours. And even if you can't go, try to find the most diverse experience that you can for your practicums and challenge yourself. If you're a white kid from a small Midwestern town, you know, you need to get out of your comfort zone and, you know, learn about privilege and power differentials and, you know, just kind of see the bigger picture in higher education, because there's just such a huge push to diversify ourselves and give opportunities to people who haven't traditionally had those opportunities to go to college and to work in higher education. And so we need to be ambassadors for that. And it was just really great to get to know our professors more and our colleagues in the doctoral program. And definitely it was worth it.
Does anyone have any questions?
Yeah, great time.
So this counts as the entirety of a practicum that we normally be taking over the summer, right?
Right. So the way it works for us is our trip was 10 days. So Dr. Mary has extended it for the next trip that goes. So we went on the trip and we did have some assignments to do. We had a book and a few other readings to do before we left. And then we had a paper to do when we got back. We had daily journals. We had about 25 of those. And then we had a presentation that we had to do. And so there are assignments that go with it, but you're completing all of your hours essentially on the trip, and then you come back and you don't have any hours, you just have follow-up assignments. And we also had a follow-up meeting where we all got together and kind of debriefed on our experience. And so that's something to look forward to as well, just to maintain those relationships. It's not just we go on the trip and we come back and don't talk again. You go on the trip and you automatically have those connections built that you're going to hopefully use otherwise.
And I mean, if you just think about it money-wise, with your assistantship and, you know, your stipend and your salary, like, your grad school is basically paid for. So if you have to take out a loan to do this, like, you know, in the long run, do it, because you're going to stand out from other people. If you didn't get a chance to study abroad in undergrad, this is your chance to teach it.
Any other questions?
Is there a limit to how many of us can go?
I've got 12 $1,000 scholarships. I have 12. First come, first serve. You all get preference to the 12 scholarships, and I'm going to open it up to the university community around mid to latter September. So you kind of have to make up your mind pretty soon whether or not you want to go with us. I'm glad the students are prestigious, because every time I look at some of these pictures at AON, I start tearing up, because it was just so phenomenal to be with these students. And I hope you all get a chance to come with me. I promise you it's going to be an amazing experience. We're going to start at, we're going to fly from Chicago this year to shorten the trip out of the United States. We're going to fly from Chicago to Amsterdam to South Africa. It takes a while to get there, but it's going to be okay. Trust me, you're going to be sleeping most of the time.
Okay.
For real, you'll be sleeping most of the time. We got about 4-hour layover in Amsterdam, so we don't have time to go out and do sightseeing there. But we did with them because they had a 10-hour layover in Frankfurt, so they got to go do some sightseeing in Germany. So we'll fly from here to Amsterdam to Cape Town. Cape Town and Stellenbosch, we will get to go to Robben's Island, which is where Mandela was held prisoner. We will get to tour University of Cape Town, University of Stellenbosch, the University of Western Cape. We'll get to go on a winery tour, because Stellenbosch is the Napa Valley of South Africa. There are over 500 wineries in that area. So we'll get to go on a winery tour. Then we will fly, and we're gonna stay at the housing facility at University of Stellenbosch, which is pretty nice. It was very nice. They have really nice international housing accommodation. We will fly from Cape Town to Johannesburg. Johannesburg will do the same thing. We'll go on a safari, University of Pretoria. We'll stay at a hotel, the Protea Hotel, which is a Marriott property, actually. And we will, visit all the campuses, talk to all student affairs folks. We'll be there during South Africa Day. We'll be there for Africa Day. We'll also be there during Open Day, which is also pretty amazing. You can tell them about, It's really kind of interesting because I just sat there in amazement at open day and sitting there in the student quad and everybody's got hookah and they're all sitting out on the quad with hookah and I'm like, wow, this is really, it's just really amazing to go and just see the difference in campus life. You know, students don't have flat screen TVs in their room. They actually talk to each other. It's really, it's like university campuses in the 70s, okay? So it's pretty cool. So then we'll fly from Joburg to France, and we have like a 10-hour to 11-hour layover in France. So we'll go out, do some sightseeing in France, and then we'll fly back here. So come, you know, it's an experience. I promise you, I'll take good care of you. Can Dr. Hinton and I will take very good care of you. You need to be passport ready. You don't have your passports, give them now. And even if you don't, even if you're not planning on going, you need to have a passport anyway. All of you should have a passport. If student affairs people, if you don't have a passport, then you can't even go to ACPA in Montreal. So you need to have a passport. Anyway, get passports. But be passport ready, and you know, all you have to do is pack your bag and have your passport, and that's it. I take care of everything. But I like, that's all you need.
And be a minimalist. You have to be a minimalist. In fact, you don't need, our creature features that we have, you just don't need all your favorite things.
Yeah.
Take one bag and then an empty bag.
Right. Well, one bag and a bag with giveaways.
And so you give it away, and so you'll come back with stuff that you've purchased. Because the strength of the dollar, if it maintains,
it is.
It's strong.
It's almost 13-1 now.
Yeah, 13 rand to $1. So you cannot imagine how far, how much stuff you can buy. I still have rand.
Okay.
I didn't spend all my rand. And so I will be taking that rand back. But you, I mean, it's just amazing the kind of things you can, your purchasing power of the dollar in South Africa. And it's, Aaron was right, a beautiful heartbreak, because as we celebrated, we also reflected. And so every night, we reflected over some good South African wine.
Okay.
We either have wine or we have rooibos tea every single night at 8:30, no matter how tired, because once we got up, like you said, you have to get up running every morning. We got up every morning running. We got up, had breakfast. We were out of the hotel most mornings by 8:30, 9 o'clock. And we didn't get back until about 8 o'clock at night, and or 8:30 at night. And then we would gather and reflect, debrief, and then the younger... they would go out to the nightlife, and they met people. They started bringing people to our sessions.
Oh, Joe,
so
we met at the club last night.
That was cool. One thing I hope you guys come to value in your assistantships here is your student interaction that you're going to get. And so that was one of the fun things that we got to do is we went out and got to have an impromptu interaction with students when we went out at night. They just said, as long as you guys are up in the morning, go have fun. And so we did, and that was great. So we got to learn about their experience as a student. We also got to just learn about them as, you know, a South African citizen. And so that was awesome as well.
Lots of parallels between that, yeah, the civil rights movement and the apartheid history, because so parallel. They may be a little further off. I don't know. We might be. They question us about the policing situation in the United States. So what's going on with that? You know, every time we ask them a question about what's going on with the barbed wire, I say, okay, what's going on with the police situation?
They approved gay marriage before the United States did.
Yes. So that's it's really it's not, you can't even read about it. You can't see a video and fully understand it. So you really need to be there, and depending on how many folks sign up, you may have to pull out of it to get you into going. Had such interest from folks from outside of our program, outside of the university community, who really want to go with us this year, that it's going to book up pretty quickly. That's not a scare tactic. It really is. But if you're at all interested, you need to sign up. I think the first payment is due in October.
Yes.
Thank you.
talk to your family group, talk to your church, talk to your people in the community, GoFundMe.com, do whatever, find your money. Folks will be willing, trust me, people are willing to invest in your education. They'll donate 25, 30, 40, 50 bucks to you. So, find some cash and come along.
Yes. So when you say sign up, is there like an application process then, or do we just send you an email? Like, how does that work?
Catherine doesn't know this yet. Catherine's my go-to person. She'll have a form ready. This year I'm going to create a form where I'll be asking you for, of course, your 991, your name, passport information. I'm going to have all of that ready early if you're interested in going. So Catherine will have that in a couple of weeks to pass out.
So as soon as you get an email, jump on it.
Okay. And this isn't the first time the only time we're going to talk to you. We'll come to your classes every now and then and just, hey, don't forget, there's a South Africa trip if you have thought any more about it. And like I said, Dr. Mary's door is always open if she's on campus. So you're always welcome to stop by and just say, hey, I'm really interested. Can I go ahead and put my name in? So if you want to do this, I would encourage you to take initiative as well.
Give until after Labor Day, but we'll have it ready for you. You interested in going?
Oh yeah,
it's
definitely.
Okay.
It's like Aaron said, it's on my bucket list, so why not?
Come on, this is safe place.
And I guarantee you, this is probably one of the cheapest ways to get there as well. I was in Africa the summer before, and I paid for that completely out of my pocket, and it was like double.
Once you include all the amenities, all the museum tickets.
Yeah.
All the transportation just to get there is probably $1,500, so that's half.
And I guarantee you, if you do this, you're gonna come back and say, I would have totally paid double just to have that experience. It's worth that much once you come back.
And you're getting college credit.
Okay.
Oh my God.
Any more questions about South Africa? Excellent. Thank you. Give us where they are. Can somebody create a slide real quick of the Vice President Banks' information, his Twitter and his Instagram, Dr. Dean's Twitter and Instagram, and then if you guys would put your email addresses up there also as a way for them to contact if they have more questions about South Africa or just any experiences. So back to the curriculum or the program in general, what questions do you have for us?
Are you allowed to, or are you not recommended to co-teach in your first year or first semester?
I'm sorry, help me out.
Okay, because with University College, I'm going to be advising conditionally admitted students, but I'm also offered to co-teach a university one-on-one course. Is that not recommended in your first semester?
We don't have any boundaries for what you get. As long as you get your coursework done, we have no boundaries for what you do outside of class.
And I think some have used that as their practicum experience, teaching University 101. I think there's some second years that are doing that.
Okay. We might want to hold off to spring and use it as practicum. Yes.
In terms of looking for practicum off campus, through St. Mary's in the Woods or if there was something in Indy, is there really any, is it just we reach out, contact them, or are there any special things?
I can touch on that.
Okay.
The previous cohort collaborated what they did, and then I added what we did. So once we get a listserv of your emails, I'll send it to you, so you'll have that.
Yeah. There's a list of contacts at some of the institutions in the area.
But we also encourage you to look beyond for what interests you and fascinates you,
yes.
Right? So. Think about what you want to do and how you want to grow as a professional as well. Aside from just, what Garion may have done last semester may have worked great for Garion, but it may not fit with what my career trajectory, you know, what I want it to look like. So.
Yeah. I think that may work if you don't really know, you might just close your eyes and pick one. But try to be as thoughtful about your practical experiences. Those are really, really valuable experiences because you get to know functional areas outside of your assistantships, right? So you're in assistantship and you get to know that area really, really well, but you can also go outside that functional area, and we recommend that you go outside so that you will start to learn and understand the full landscape of higher ed.
And the other piece, sorry, I keep kind of jumping in, but the other piece is that this is the only student affairs program in the country that has you do 3 practicums as your core curriculum, right? Some have them have the situation where you can opt to do an extra, but usually 2 is the minimum. So really take advantage of this opportunity because it really is one of the things that's going to set you above the rest of the pool who's applying for jobs once you're a graduate. So think about that as well.
And we've had 100% placement.
Yep.
From our May graduates. So we typically don't have, our students don't have any problems, and we believe that it's connected to the free practical experience. Does everybody have my contact information? I don't hold office hours per se. If you need to make an appointment with me, do so by appointment. And faculty members will post any office hours that they would like to, or most of the time it's by appointment with them as well. But if you see our doors open on the 3rd floor, feel free to pop in anytime.
I'm usually here on Wednesdays and Thursdays.
Yes.
I mean, all day. Yeah. And then Fridays, I'm kind of not interested. I'm not around that one. Mondays and Tuesdays, I'm in meetings. So, but Wednesdays and Thursdays, you can find me in the building.
Yes. Same thing.
I know you guys have questions. I know you do. Based on the looks on your faces, you've got a million things running through your mind.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, and somebody else is probably asking the same question. So,
sure.
Yes.
As far as for the assistantships, do we need to, like, as far as filling out like an I-9 for employment and stuff, is that through our own supervisor for assistantships, or is that through the Bi College of Education?
So that what's the question?
Like, I haven't filled out like anything for my employment at all for the university for my assistantship. Do I go to my supervisor for that, or do
yes.
I go?
Yes.
Okay.
That's,
yes.
Okay.
So just make sure,
cool.
You know, just go to them and make sure that you have all of your HR information complete, and just ask them, you know, have I completed everything for human resources, and then they'll move you through.
Alrighty, thank you.
You'll have to go to the career center too.
Okay.
But you can do it as soon as you have that paperwork.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Is everybody else settled in your assistantships? Getting that big paycheck? Okay, those have to be poor for another couple of years.
And after that,
you'll get your
PhD. Anything else? Any more questions? Comments? Concerns?
I have another question about the teaching. I was asked to ask this. If I did it for one semester, if I did it 2 semesters, I can only use it as a practicum
once.
For 1 semester. Okay. Okay.
When you guys are setting up your practicums, you don't like need to start this week, but don't wait until the last minute, especially if you want to do it on another campus, because sometimes there's like a miscommunication, or sometimes they need to check their schedules as well. So maybe like halfway through the semester, start really thinking about who you need to contact in order to do your practicums.
And there is a practicum handbook on our website as well that probably about midway through the semester in your introduction course, Dr. Walker will probably tie that in so that you can just be familiar with it and start to get an idea of what is it that we're talking about and what are the expectations of a practicum, you know, because there are different steps involved in that process.
Yes. On that note, we set them up in class or we expect you to set them up on our own?
Set them up on your own. But you'll get a lot of in-class information about halfway through, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, with your practicum, you do have an actual class that you physically have every week, unless the teacher decides otherwise, but you meet, and but that doesn't count towards your practicum hours. You have your 100 hours outside of your assistantship and your classes and anything else that you're responsible for.
And you'll be able to get it all done.
Time management. That's going to be your best friend.
Yes, you'll be amazed at what you can get done. You'll be able to get it all done. Mm-hmm. And when you leave here, you'll be so prepared for the real world. Academic world.
So I have a few very quick tidbits. One is, become familiar with the library. Become familiar with your library. We have a liaison to the library named Ms. Campbell, and she will be a huge resource for all of you. But in addition, there is something called the Math and Writing Center. I don't know if you all are familiar about that yet, but that is a place that as students you're able to submit your papers and have someone help with APA, editing, grammar, you know, wherever you may need a little bit of assistance in structure and making sure that you're following the guidelines that the professor provides. And you can, I mean, that's a free service. You're already paying for that. So be sure you take advantage of those. Those little things can really help and will make your experience, again, with time management and, you know, getting acclimated to a new campus and all of those things, learning all those little incidentals can save you significant time and really enrich your experience. So those are just some quick tips that I learned as a student here. And also, like Bart said, use the rec center. It's great. I think it's, what, one of the top 10 in the country? Bart. He was the second speaker. Bart. But it's one of the top 10 rec centers in the country. So really, utilize it. It's great.
And then just another piece of advice. Your cohort, you guys are going to go through everything together for the next 2 years. And so use this first couple of weeks to kind of start to build your support system. Not saying you're going to be best friends with everybody, but you guys are going to be colleagues and represent each other professionally, literally from this point on through your career. So build your support system because you're going to need it throughout the next 2 years. And don't get overwhelmed by like the readings and the assignments. Like, when you find that support system, divide things up. You take chapter one, you take chapter two, make notes, and share them. That's going to get you through the next 2 years.
Great advice. Our recommendation is that you get some kind of a Google Groups or Google Hangout or something where you have a Dropbox where you can share information. And again, you are a cohort, so connect with each other in that way. You're going to be taking all your classes together. You'll be doing group work together at different times. You'll be in different groups. Please take advantage of being in a cohort. You have to lean on each other. This is not a race, so to speak. There's no winner in it. You all win together, right? So you're not in competition with each other. You were competing with each other to get into the program. That piece is over. You're now a cohort. So you have to work together. Don't try to, you know, covet or hide anything from your cohort that you might share. You will have different strengths. Somebody will be in your groups, you will be strong. Someone is a strong writer. Someone is a strong speaker. Someone has a strength in organizing. Your strengths will be different. But you collectively, you will make those strengths as one and be successful together. So you know, we are sticklers in our program for APA. The APA manual is a must. You have to purchase with the rest of your books. We advise that you get the spiral bound one so that you can keep it flipped open. When you get your first set of papers back and it's all marked up, don't be thin-skinned and start crying. like, you know, just don't do it. We're going to make you better. You're going to be strong writers. By the time you write your thesis or your capstone projects, you'll be very proficient in APA, because we will be dogged when it comes to APA. So learn backwards and forward. You'll get marked up. Don't be discouraged by that, but you know, so you might say thank you for the feedback, because we will give you a lot of feedback as it relates to APA. Anything else?
Have fun.
Yes.
Don't just be a cohort in the classroom. Be a cohort outside of the classroom as well. Go to football games and go to dinner for your birthdays and like get to know each other. You don't want to just be part of the classroom. You need each other outside of it too.
And get to know the second years. We're here to help. There's not a wall between the two cohorts. So.
In a few minutes, you'll get to meet more second year and some professionals from the field, some student affairs professionals from around campus. So, you know, you'll be engaged with a lot of student affairs folks. Again, this is your academic home right here in the College of Ed. You're your academic peeps. My Twitter information is Candace Hinton on Twitter, Candace Hinton on Instagram, Candace Hinton on Facebook. Friend me, follow me, I'll follow you back. Dr. Mary, what are you on Twitter? I think she's
Dr. Mary.
I think it is.
Mary Howard on Twitter. And then once you get to one of our...
Mary Howard Hamilton at Mary Howard, yeah, something like that.
Yes. So you'll find us, follow us, and we try to be profound. My personal is my professional, so basically what I say on my page is what I say in life in general, so I have nothing to hide, really. I don't think. but, you know, and there it is. So, anything else? Look to the yard. All right, enjoy those rose clips. see you in a few days. Thank you. Get some more snacks, and then if you would just make a beeline to the atrium. There's more food down there. They've got a little program planned for you there, and we'll see you soon. Good luck.